sit around. Reinhardt, three bounces off the dasher. Hall has the puck fall. Trent Frederick, off glass and out, and it oscillates and slows down. No icing. 1 minute to go, separating the Buffalo Sabres from tying two other teams for the second longest losing streak in NHL history. Connor Clifton over the glass. It just caught the top of the glass.
Yeah, you could see it change direction ever so slightly, and you were hoping for it if you were a Bruins fan and a Bruins player. You didn't need a 6-on-4 situation in this case. Wants to go up the glass and out. Just catches a piece right there.
Quarter of an inch higher, and that is a 2-minute penalty. Game report brought to you by Sullivan Tire and Auto Service. We're always here to get you there. Timeout, I believe, called by Buffalo. Yeah, 16 straight losses coming into today. Longest in the NHL in 17 years. Ties Washington's mark of 17. In 40 seconds, tied by San Jose in 1993. Pittsburgh tanked for Sid the Kid. 18 in a row, the all-time NHL record for a losing streak. In 2004, I would say that Pittsburgh fans would agree with me unanimously that it was worth the suffering. Turns the goal, loosens the slot, a scramble for the puck, and it's tied up, or is there a penalty shot?
I'm not sure what the signal is, but he's calling something.
John McIsaac.
He did not give the penalty shot signal. He's calling a minor penalty, I believe.
Cross-checking. Goaltender interference.
Well, not doing everything he could with his big body to keep this puck from getting across the goal line. He had to stay deep on the wraparound. Here's an opportunity. And the wrist of line is in there, just in a battle with all kinds of bodies. He gives it a little extra shove with that left forearm and arm. The referee directly behind the net. Probably he had a great look at it. They had the willingness to make a call.
Okay, Magar took a beating, but I defy anyone to make organization out of that chaos.
Yeah, it was just that extra aggressive push with the left arm and his sticking across checking position.
Yeah.
You know, but he's got pressure on his backside, Mr. Lannan does, so he feels like he's entitled. You know, because it's a battle in there. I certainly thought that it was intentional.
Well,
because he had a little response to it.
Yeah. Being the goalie.
Yeah. And it's a big call.
Yeah.
25 seconds to go in regulation. Now you got a 5-on-4 situation.
Final 15 seconds. Buffalo pulls the goalie again. Olofsson's shot saved by Vladar. Bergeron with the empty net misses wide, and the Buffalo Sabres stand with the Washington Caps of 1975 and the San Jose Sharks of 1993. 17 consecutive losses, the second longest in NHL history. The Bruins pull out a 3-2 win at TD Garden.
Think back to later stages of the second period. The Bruins down 2-1. Jack, we talked about it. It wasn't about X's and O's at that point if you were the Boston Bruins. It's, we got to do whatever we can to win a hockey game. They had the will, they had the desire. It wasn't the prettiest. but some key players made some big plays for the Bruins to get a 3-2 victory. 15-2 shots on goal margin in the third period. Save of the game brought to you by TD Bank.
Yeah, early in the hockey game, Lennar in goal. Just a second spot in the Bruins uniform. Yeah, the Buffalo Sabres. But they got some guys that can score some goals. Casey Middlestead gets an early opportunity and a fucking squeeze through was on. And a good reaction by Vladar. Had to be quick, had to be aggressive, had to stay big, had to be agile. He was all of that.
Vladar, his second victory in a row, making it a happy birthday or a happier birthday for Dale.